Hi viewers, so this is Ravi Shankar. You are watching Ravi's biology channel. So in the last video, so we have discussed about dicot root, dicotyledonous root, internal structure of dicotyledonous root. In this video, we are going to discuss about monocot root. So like dicot root, monocot has differentiated into three important zones. So monocot root also differentiated into three important zones. What are they? Epidermis, cortex and stele. Epidermis, cortex and stele. So all the characters like dicot root. So in the monocot root, all the characters are similar to the dicot root in the epidermis. So epidermis, we have discussed already about epidermis. Epidermis is the uniseriate, single layered. So with compactly arranged without any parenchymatous cells, without any intercellular spaces. And also it is a protective layer, and also epidermal cells, extension of epidermal cells shows unicellular root haze, and also some stomata, cuticle is absent in the epidermis. So all these characters, so in dicot roots, are similar to the monocot root. Okay, so epidermis one. So second one, cortex. Cortex also exodermis, also general cortex, endodermis. So cortex also, it has also differentiated into three important zones. Exodermis, general cortex and endodermis. So it already in the dicot root, see that ones. Exodermis is the layer beneath the epidermis, 2 to 3 rows of layers. So with supervised cells, so acts like a exodermis. So it is present beneath the epidermis. So when epidermis is removed, so it acts like a epidermis. Exodermis acts like a epidermis. Next layer, general cortex. General cortex is a parenchymatous, with the parenchymatous cells. So with the intercellular spaces, parenchymatous cells, loosely arranged cells. So in the general cortex, with the intercellular spaces. In the epidermis, intercellular spaces are absent, but in the general cortex, intercellular spaces are present. So general cortex also stored food materials, okay, and also useful for the conduction of water and food materials. And also third one, endodermis. Endodermis, we have already discussed about this one. So contains casparian stripes, barrel shaped cells are arranged in the single layered cell. Endodermis is also innermost layer of the cortex. Innermost layer of the cortex. So endodermis, the cells are uniseriates, single layered cells. So endodermis, in the endodermis cells contains some cells with suberin and lignin. So due to the deposition of suberin and lignin, so these thickenings are called casparian stripes. So we have already discussed in the dicot root. See that one. So casparian stripes also present, and also some passive cells. Without any casparian stripes, some cells are present. So towards the protoxylem, without the casparian stripes, these cells are called passive cells. Passive cells are useful for the conduction of water and salts from cortex to the stele. So we have discussed all. Same characters are similar to the monocot root. Also stele, the stele pericycle, three zones are there. So pericycle, vascular bundles, also pith or medulla. So pericycle is the outermost layer of stele, outermost layer of stele. So most important character in the pericycle, so pericycle gives lateral roots. So lateral roots are originated from the pericycle, most important character for the examinations. So pericycle gives lateral roots, very important one for the examinations. So previously asked question, this is the important one, pericycle. And also next one, vascular bundles. So vascular bundles, also radial type of vascular bundles are present in the monocot root. So except what are the character in the dicot root? Tetrarch type of condition, monarch to octarch. So more usually tetrarch type of xylem is present, but in the monocot root, polyarch See here. So, in the monocot root, polyarch type of xylem is present. So many bundles. That's the, I mean, so many xylem vessels are arranged in the monocot root. So, this is the important character, differentiate character. So, dicot root and monocot. So, polyarch type of xylem vessels is present in the monocot root. Okay. Next one, secondary growth is absent in the monocot root. Next important character. So, another important one, pith or medulla. In the dicot root, pith or medulla is completely absent. When it is present, less development in the dicot root with the parenchymatous cells. But in the monocot, so well developed pith is present. This is the important character for monocot root. Well developed pith or medulla is present in the monocot root. So, most important characters, the monocot root, three characters are there. What are they? Polyarch type of xylem vessels are present, and also well developed medulla or pith is present in the monocot root. So, remaining all characters are similar to the dicot root. Also, secondary growth is absent in the monocot root. Okay, so these are the important points for the monocot root. So, see that, see in my video dicot root ones. So, very important for the examinations. So, dicot root and monocot root. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching.